Welcome back, y'all. Thank you for tuning in. Today, I'm gonna be changing out the coolant filter on my 7.3 Ford Powerstroke diesel. And I'm pretty excited about it because I'm gonna cut into it and see what kind of stuff it trapped. I think I've had it on for about, 4,000 miles. So let's get started. So I just parked the truck and now I'm gonna get to taking off the old coolant filter off. And it's actually, let me show you the bracket. It's actually pretty interesting. Little hack I did. This is an XDP filter off of a 6.0. And I adapted a bracket right here to the radiator support and ran my own lines. And I put these off of also, I took these also off of the 6.0, but they're like shut off valves that way. Whenever you change the filter, you can just shut them off and minimal fluid actually leaks out. But as far as like the connections go, you just tee up the reservoir right here, you tee it up, and the other connection, that like the inlet, this is like the outlet. So the inlet hose goes right here to the water pump. There's like a little plug right there, you take it off and then you put the hose right there. So this is the first time I'm gonna be changing it out. So I'm gonna be cutting into it and I'm curious to see what's going to be in there. So the coolant that I've changed out of the engine has been pretty clean, so I'm not too worried about it being dirty or like corroded, but I'm so curious to see like what actually gets filtered through it, because I know some people don't ever put filters in them, and then some people are like diehard, you have to have a coolant filter on here. So I'm kind of curious to see like, do they really work? But let's get started on this. So first I'm going to close up the valves right here. These are just stainless steel valves, and I did paint them all just because I hated all the mismatched colors, and the sealant that I put on there was green and you could see it, so I wanted it, all the brass and everything, to be uniform, so I painted everything black. So all I got to do is close it up and then spin this off and we get to doing that. Okay, so I just broke it free, so now I'm gonna spin it off, and there, it's starting a leak right there. I do have a tray in the bottom catching all the fluid. I know this is poisonous to animals, so I don't want any dogs or cats licking the stuff. Okay, so I ran into some problems and a lot of fluid was leaking out more than I'd like for it to be. Like right here, it was getting the, making a mess with the boot. And so I got a little tray right here. I don't know if you can see it. I got this tray right here and I just put it underneath it. So I'm gonna try to spin it off now while having the fluid leak on to the tray right here. So I'm dumping it out and now you can see like actual rust coming out. You can see it's like different colors right there. Like that middle part, it does seem to have like little particles at the very bottom. You can see all that little like brown like particles floating around. I don't know if it's from the filter right here, because you can see it's a little rusty right there, or from the actual engine block. So I don't know. All right, I just finished cutting up the filter and I decided to hacksaw it because, you know, why not have some fun with it. So let's get this filter and see what's inside of it. I had to cut myself, break some pliers. All right, I got the pliers. Let's take a tour. Laboratory right there. All right, let's dig in, see what's in here. I don't know, I can't really see anything. Like right off the bat, it's not really noticeably dirty, or like I don't see any particulates in there. See if y'all can zoom into that part. Like, I do see some shavings, but that might be from when I opened it up. Look inside of it. Yeah, you can kind of see some stuff, like right here. So you put it up to like the light. See right there, you can kind of see some particles, but not anything too bad. I'm gonna keep digging in and like try to find something. All right, so the more I look into it, and I am seeing that it does have a lot of stuff inside of it right here. I'm gonna try to cut open a get the knife. I'm gonna cut a part of it off. Like right here. Look at that. That is stuff that was in my engine block. And overall, like this area right here, this is like gunk right there. You can tell that's like actual mud or something that's like caked on there. I don't know if maybe that was in the filter to begin with. I don't know. But yeah, you can see this stuff right here. That's not, that shouldn't be in there. I'd rather it be here, but you know, instead of the engine, I'm gonna run a towel right through it. Yeah, it's pretty minimal. I'm actually shocked that it's actually this little bit. I thought it'd capture more, so overall it's pretty good, but in some areas you do see, like right here, there are more particles right there. I'm gonna cut open a different area. And like right there, you can see there's sludge down there. Let me get a different area. Okay, yeah, that's more like it right here. That's dirty right there. All right, so now I'm gonna put the new filter on. And all I gotta do is just screw it into place and then open up the two valves that I have right there. All right, so as far as replenishing the fluid that I took out, I'm gonna run the truck a little bit and then I'm gonna add whatever, after it cycles through, whatever is missing. It wasn't more than a few ounces, so it's not gonna do much harm to it. So after seeing what's in that filter, I'm kind of shocked. Like, that's proof right there to me that you should always have a coolant filter. I don't understand why people run no filters at all. And I'm kind of shocked at how and why companies such as Ford back in the day didn't even put any filters like this in their vehicles. And like, I don't know about the newer trucks if they have them, but like that's like right off the bat, like you should have filtration systems for every kind of system in your vehicle. That's a no-brainer for me. So I really would like to work on the OBS next. That is Boney's truck. And it's a dually Centurion OBS. It's beautiful. And I think he's wanting to install more lights on it. It's already looking like a Christmas tree, but he's gonna put on more lights in it. So I'm actually pretty happy about that. Here at Tamale Garage, we never say no to more lights. Thanks for watching. And if you wanna see more videos like this, please subscribe to our channel. We're gonna be putting out two videos a week, Monday and Thursday. So I will see you on the next one.